It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. Say it best when you say nothing at all.
Today is a day of love and promise. The day on which Kate and Nate have come together to stand up before those people who matter most to them and declare their lifetime commitment to one another. They have asked us here to witness the joining of their lives together and celebrate their future as husband and wife. This next step in your lives together that lays before you is the natural result of a seed planted long ago, tended and nurtured as you shared adventures and dates, love and laughter. through sushi sundaes, cooking hundreds of meals, picnics in Forest Park, countless mussels ordered, and even some stuff that doesn't directly involve food, you found in each other the perfect complement. It's said that true love is a soul's recognition of its counterpoint in another. We will now have a reading from Katie.
Gives me a chance to thank you for the miracle of you. You are and always will be the love of my life.
Marriage is a bond of trust between two people requiring an openness of life and thought, free from doubt and suspicion, and commitment to speak the truth in love to one another. Marriage is also a bond of hope that endures all things, in which you commit yourselves to interpret each other with understanding and compassion, to never give up trying to communicate with each other as you love and care for one another. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, there's a vast and unknown future stretching out before you. The possibilities and potentials of your married life are great, and now falls upon you the task of choosing your values and realizing your dream. Through your commitment to each other, may you grow and nurture a love that makes both of you better people, a love that continues to give you great joy and also a passion for living that provides you with the energy and patience to face the responsibilities of life, especially if it means going to the gym or using those gym muscles to do the dishes. At this time, we will have a second reading from Kelly.
You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decide to marry. From that moment of yes, to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making commitments in an informal way. All of those conversations that were held in the car, or over a meal, or over long walks, all of those conversations that began with, well, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will, all those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe, all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart, all these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we promised and hoped and dreamed. Well, I meant it, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, even teacher. For you have learned so much from one another these past few years. Shortly, you shall say a few words that will take you across the threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
Today, each of you are stating to the world that you are committing to the growth and well-being of your partner, that you are pledging your love and support for each other at all times. These are not things that can be mandated by the state, and these are not things that can be dictated by legal contract. These are pledges you make in your hearts, with your hearts, to one another and no one else. With this in mind, I'll now ask you to take your vows. And Nate, even though you tried to use email and text to ask Kate out for the first time, you have to have your Will you, Nate, offer yourself to Kate as your spouse, your friend, your lover, and your lifelong companion? Will you share your life with her, build your dreams together, support her through times of trouble, and rejoice with her in times of happiness? Will you treat her with respect, love, and loyalty through all the trials and triumphs of your lives together? Will you, Kate, offer yourself to Nate as your spouse, your friend, your lover, and your lifelong companion? Will you share your life with him, build your dreams together, support him through times of trouble, and rejoice with him in times of happiness? Will you treat him with respect, love, and loyalty through all the trials and triumphs of your lives together? The ring is. The unbroken circle of the ring represents many things. It is a symbol of endless devotion with no beginning and no end. And let these rings be a physical representation of your commitment to one another. Let them remind you of the promises you have made to one another in the past, the promises you make to one another here today, and the promises you will make to one another as you forge a future together. With this ring, I commit myself to us. Your dreams I will share. Your burdens I will bear. From now until forever, I will be incomplete without you. With this ring, I commit myself to us. Your dreams I will share. Your burdens I will bear. From now until forever. I will be incomplete without you. If anyone knows any reason why these two may not be legally joined in matrimony, please keep quiet until after the reception. But do please remember to sign the guest book. You came to me as two individuals, and you will now leave the joint couple, united to each other in matrimony. But what is most important is the love that you share, a love that transcends language, law, and ritual. You must remember to cherish this most wonderful gift for the rest of your lives. And so, by the power vested in me by the state of Connecticut, I now pronounce you married. And that, kids, is how I married your mother and father. Now start kissing and let's party. Thank you.
introduce my a cappella group, Strike a Chord.
I may not make it through this.
You got this.
I got this. We've prepared a song for Kate. Yes, okay, for both of us. But it's more me for Kate.
Ringing in my head for you.
My head.
All of our friends and family to join them.
To do some navigating.